Welcome to Popcorn Planet. I am Andy Signor. Now, previously, we'd already talked about the fact that Amber is up for potential perjury charges over in Australia regarding the whole dog debacle, where she forced her own assistant to lie and get these dogs in. Australia has a whole strict, you know, rules as to what you can bring over and not over the border. And she just ignored those orders. And the Australian FBI, the authorities there, they're not happy with her. Well, it turns out here in the States, experts are saying she could face jail over perjury charges in this case, currently in Fairfax, against Johnny Depp. Now, experts are warning her that she absolutely could, because witnesses and experts who were saying before that, oh yeah, it's very unlikely, they're now changing their tune. As reported here, defamation lawyer Aaron Mink has said more and more objective evidence that she is lying about things under oath could lead to a sentence for the actress. Now, asked previously, she said it was like whatever, but now as the closing and more things have come forward, he's changed his mind. This one expert changed his mind, saying, I think that as this case goes on, we see more and more objective evidence that she's lying about things under oath, that when it starts crossing the line of the possibility that she is fabricating evidence, fabricating photos, fabricating bruises, altering evidence, and then submitting it. Mink warned fabricating evidence is not only really serious, but also really offensive to the justice system, obviously. He said, I would hope that prosecutors would take a close look at it, because if there's very clear evidence that she did that, that should certainly be considered. If it was proven that that was the case, there's certainly some questions being raised in the trial currently that could potentially lead to a criminal prosecution and jail time. Oh my goodness. My goodness. Now, obviously, a previous partner at the law firm told the Mail Online that yes, she could face perjury charges in the UK as misleading the courts there, which cuts to the core of our justice system. I mean, imagine if the UK court is so frazzled, they're like, oh, yeah, we have to revisit this now, too, after they ignored Johnny Depp's chance for appeal. The whole UK verdict was insane. But now, asked if he could see police investigating claims that she may have lied her oath about donating her $7 million, he said, yes, I think so. While it may not be a central issue, the case, perjury is the single biggest threat and cuts to the core of our justice system. So the police may be invited to investigate to show that any member of the public who lies to the court can be prosecuted for perjury. I mean, guys, that's how it should be. The fact that they aren't taking this seriously is really frustrating. I know we've talked to Christopher Melcher. I tried to get him on this video, but I'm hoping we'll have him on soon, and I'll ask him his thoughts on this. But he sort of made it clear to me that he thinks it's a very hard shot. I'm sure he still believes that. But my God, as more and more comes forward, it's hard to not want to just push for this justice to ensure that she be used as an example, because so much of this is proving to be problematic. There's something blowing my nose. I'm not sorry. No, I don't have my tissue to snort. there we go. But anyway, as we go through this, it's just wild to see that experts are now coming around to say, yeah, Amber, you're in trouble. There's a lot of other really good pieces coming out. I saw this article the other day that I wanted to mention as well. It's just I couldn't agree more. We can't let Amber Heard's melodramatic whining about internet trolls close American courtrooms. There are so many think pieces being written right now trying to talk about how she's, you know, the victim when she's the actual one doing it to Johnny. And should never be allowed to guilt us into stopping both mocking her and others on her on the internet and opening courts to live streaming. She took the stand probably against her counsel's advice last Thursday and proceeded to whine about being mocked on the internet and claim that people want to, you know, threaten her, etc. Maybe that happened, but considering her track record for telling the truth, I have my doubts. The media is determined to help her look as victim-y as possible, which is incredibly hard to do since the world watched the trial and has a very different opinion of Ms. Heard. Big media has been busy writing garbage articles like this one. This one infuriated me. Variety. Why was Depp Heard trial televised? Critics call it the single worst decision for DV victims. I mean, my God, they're all blaming Penny Escarita. I don't say it. Judge Penny for this decision. But my God, this idea that we shouldn't publicize the court system. I mean, I think back to what we did with Britney and Free Britney. And I know some people are still now worried. Is she stuck again? We have all this stuff, all these examples of cases where, why don't we want some sort of check and system? We got body cams on officers. Why can't we have body cams on judges? It's incredibly important to have all that documented. It's shocking to me that there's people out there who are saying, oh no, this should have never been televised. Why? So they could have covered this up? We would have never gotten the amount of details we did. We would have never had as much support for Johnny that we now have if we didn't have this be public, because the truth was exposed. And I want to talk about some of these lies, because a lot of you guys have sent me this TMZ clip, which seems to admit that, yeah, once again, yet another lie that we've caught Amber. Now, before I even get there, I want to take a moment to point out this video. I'm going to put it at the end of the video as well. I hope you'll go support it. It's a really great video we put together that really breaks down a lot of her lies, her hypocrisy, and her final plea to the jury. So if you haven't already, make sure you check that out. Again, I'll remind you at the end of this video. Hopefully, you'll click it over and watch that next. But here's TMZ basically admitting... Sure. That, yeah.
Well, that's the first thing I notice in this video is that
they're discussing the video. I got to be careful. TMZ is the worst in trying to get pieces here. But she's, you know, talking
puts
about
this camera down on the table.
He's explaining exactly what we've already seen. The fact that
she starts filming because she knows the way this argument's going to go.
There it is.
And wants to get academy. Whatever he says or does on tape. If you notice halfway through the video, she moves the camera.
Yeah, we noticed it. We noticed it, buddy. I mean, it's hard to ignore.
So that it gets the angle of Johnny Depp so that he's on camera.
Then she like hides it with her cup even further. She's like putting the cup in like, oh, he's gone. He's back. I will let you see him now.
Now, the other thing that I have to say, Amber thinks by leaking this video is going to go a long way for her.
Well, what did you just say? What did you just say there?
By leaking this video is going to go a long way for her. The other thing that I have to say, Amber thinks by leaking this video is going to go a long way for her.
I want to hear that one more time. Let's blow that up. Make sure we heard that one more time with there's the subtitles on screen.
Now, the other thing that I have to say, Amber thinks by leaking this video is going to go a long way for her.
So TMZ, when they released said video, actually acknowledged that it was leaked by Amber. Of course it was leaked by Amber. We always knew this was leaked by Amber. She even messed up during the deposition. She can't help herself. She is perjuring herself. She's lying under oath. I hope the system actually pays attention here and does something about it. Add to that the fact that in Australia, I didn't know this one either. This has been going around and I talked to our own Matt Bond, who's in Australia. He agreed. Glassing, I never heard of it. But it's a severe thing in Australia. You can get in some serious trouble if you use a glass against someone else. It's called glassing. And I did look this up. A lot of you guys have been sending this to me. And yeah, I've talked to some people in Australia that it is a serious crime out there. And so for the fact that she threw the bottle at his finger, that's technically glassing, and technically Amber is in trouble. My God, girl, I don't know what you're thinking. Meanwhile, quick Johnny update. He received a standing ovation at London's Royal Hall. He did a concert with Jeff Beck doing some music covers. He did John Lennon's Isolation, Marvin Gaye's What's Going On, and the audience loved it. Audience cheered like crazy when he showed up. But who was unhappy with this? You know, E. Fartlow. So Johnny's on tour with Jeff Beck. He played Sheffield and likely play the Royal Hall. That's like DV waiting for his defamation case for the one who's been canceled. Oh, God, Eve Barlow, you are literally the worst. And that's why Eve Barlow is a joke, is trending. People have also unearthed told tweets of her standing Kate Moss and even Johnny. It's shocking to me. But there's Amber's little crony always carrying the groceries for Amber. Defending her girlfriend. What a surprise that she's out there constantly doing this. But anyway, lots more to go through. We'll be live later today. So many more videos as we wait for the jury to come back and give us their verdict. We will be live as soon as it happens, I assure you. So make sure, if you haven't already, hit that subscribe button, hit the bell for all alerts while you're there, smash the like button, and leave a comment down below to ensure you don't miss our reaction as well as the verdict itself. And again, reminder, please check out the video there on the left. Amber lied. If you missed that one and didn't get as much in the algorithm, go share that one. Go check it out. It's amazing to see all her lies juxtaposed together. Appreciate you guys. Stay tuned for more here on Popcorn Planet.